Good morning students, we are going to learn about carbon and its compounds from chapter 4. We know that there are about 118 elements in the universe. Of these 118 elements, we are going to study about carbon because it has attained a special place due to its unique properties. Why this carbon is considered to be so special? Almost many of the things that we use in our daily life contains carbon in it. The food we eat, clothes we wear, medicines we use, fuels, plastics, paints, dyes, everything contains carbon. It is one of the most essential elements for life. With the help of carbon cycle, it is easy to understand about the presence and importance of carbon. Carbon is present in the atmosphere as carbon dioxide, and this carbon dioxide is used by the plant for photosynthesis for preparing the food called as glucose, which is C6H12O6. Animals and human beings depends on these plants for their food, and this carbon as carbohydrates and proteins enters into their body. When these plants and animals die, they get buried under the earth, and after millions of years, it slowly gets converted into coal and petroleum by the process of carbonization. And burning these fossil fuels for getting energy, carbon is again released into the air, and it combines with the oxygen present in the air to form carbon dioxide. From this carbon cycle, we can clearly understand that carbon is present everywhere, and also this carbon is essential for both existence and the survival of the life in the earth. In the year 1808, a scientist named Berzelius, while studying about carbon compounds, proposed vital force theory. In his theory, he said carbon compounds are present in living organisms, and these compounds cannot be prepared artificially in the laboratory, and they are available only in the living organisms and also in natural sources. But his theory was proved wrong by the scientist Friedrich Holler. He said carbon compounds can be prepared in the lab artificially, and he succeeded in preparing the first artificial carbon compound urea in his lab from the inorganic mineral ammonium cyanide. After his discovery, many other scientists tried to prepare a lot of carbon compounds in the lab and got millions of carbon compounds like synthetic fibers, plastics, drugs, paints, perfumes, and so a separate branch of chemistry was started to study about these compounds, and it was named as organic chemistry and also living chemistry, and sometimes called as chemistry of carbon compounds. Occurrence of carbon. Carbon occurred in a combined state in the air as carbon dioxide is 0.03% and in the earth as carbonates, hydrocarbonates in 0.02% and also as coal and charcoal. And in the free state, it is present in the form of diamond and graphite, which are considered to be the purest form of carbon. Carbon is a non-metal. Its atomic number is 6 and mass number is 12. Its electronic configuration is 2, 4. Carbon atom is valency 4, and it shares 4 electrons with other atoms to form a stable compound. This property is called as tetravalency. Carbon cannot gain 4 electrons to form anion because 4 protons cannot hold 10 electrons present in the shells. And also, carbon cannot lose 4 electrons and become a cation because it requires large amount of energy to remove the electrons, and with 2 electrons, atom will be unstable. So, carbon shares 4 electrons to form a stable octet configuration. Because of this sharing, carbon is said to be tetravalent in nature. Carbon has one more property called as catenation. When the carbon shares electron with itself to form a compound, it is called catenation. This self-linking property of carbon forms a straight chain compound, a branched chain, or a closed chain compounds. These two properties, tetravalency and catenation, helps carbon to form a huge number of compounds. The third property is allotropy. Carbon compounds that are chemically similar and physically different are called as allotropes. Carbon can exist in 3 allotropic forms as diamond and graphite, and the artificially synthesized fullerene form, and also as amorphous form as coal and charcoal. Diamond in the crystalline form of carbon, in which one carbon is linked to four other carbon atoms to form tetrahedral 3D structures. As all the carbon atoms are linked with four bonds, all the bonds are strong, diamond is hard. Due to 3D structure, it can reflect light, so diamond is shiny in appearance. Next is graphite. In graphite, one carbon is linked to three other carbon atoms to form hexagonal layers, and each hexagonal layer slides over each other and they are connected with weak van der Waals forces. Because of this, graphite is soft and slippery. And also, as only carbon atoms are connected to three other carbon atoms, one electron is left free. Because of that, it can conduct electricity. Next form is fullerene. Fullerene is made up of 60 carbon atoms linked with 12 pentagons and 20 hexagons in the form of a soccer ball. This fullerene is named after an US architect, Buckminster Fuller, who constructed geodesic dome. This dome was similar to that of this form of carbon, so it was named as fullerene. The next allotropic form of carbon is amorphous form, which is coal and charcoal. We know this coal is obtained from the dead vegetation by the carbonization, and the charcoal is obtained from the burning of wood.